The Commonwealth Bank yesterday. Tonight, another Australian financial pylon, Telstra, is in the news. Eddie Meyer is here in the studio. And Eddie, as I understand it, there are a couple of quite different reasons for getting your attention, Telstra, today.
There are, George, and one of them has a very ugly number attached to it. Australia's biggest phone company has announced a six-month net profit today of just under $1.2 billion. Now, that sounds a lot, but it's actually down a whopping 36%. Of course, that's more than a third. But CEO David Thodey says don't despair. The company has spent a fortune attracting 900,000 new customers, and they, in the long run, will help jack up Telstra's bottom line.
So the way this industry works is when you acquire a customer, you expense it up front and you then get the profits over the next 12 to 24 months. It's purely a timing of when you take the cost. Therefore, shareholders should be very pleased with the exceptional growth in customers, the largest growth we've had in over a decade.
At the same time, the company has finalised commercial terms with the federal government over the national broadband network. It gives the NBN access to the telco's assets for the rollout. In return, Telstra gets $11 billion in long-term payments.
I think that it's important for this country to move forward in terms of fast access broadband, and I think that's very good. And I think there's many ways that that can happen. The government's made their decision. My job now is to work with them to work out the best thing for Telstra shareholders.
Now, Mr. Thodey will put that deal to those shareholders for approval in July. And it's worth noting, George, that Telstra's share price was down slightly today.
And I noticed the NBN has raised its head again. Stay
Absolutely.
Tuned. Thanks, Eddie.